Now, if you've seen our golf fitter preview of the Rogue driver, you'll most likely be wondering what is the difference between the standard Rogue and this Rogue Sub-Zero, and which one is right for you. Now, before I get onto the target market of the Rogue Sub-Zero, let's recap some of the technology it shares with the standard Rogue, like the upgraded jailbreak bars for serious ball speeds across the face, the light, thin triaxial carbon crown, the big stretched out 460cc head for anti-twist stability or high moment of inertia in the strike, and adjustability in the loft sleeve. But what makes the Rogue Sub-Zero different to the standard Rogue is the presence of two interchangeable 2 gram and 12 gram weights in the sole. When that heavier 12 gram weight is in the forward position, the Rogue Sub-Zero becomes a very low spinning driver, best suited to fast swinging players, low handicappers, elite players, tour players who want that knuckleball style drive for distance, but have that extra control needed to keep it on the fairway. Now, if you're a wristy player, a late striker, or tend to strike down steeply on the ball and whose poor drive is a spinny, high, almost balloon flight, even though you've hit it hard, the Sub-Zero with the right shaft will bring that spin down and could also be a game changer for you. The drawn out high MOI crown of the Rogue Sub-Zero compared to its predecessor, the Epic Sub-Zero, should make it inherently more forgiving, and don't be surprised to see a little more fade bias in your drives. In summary, the Rogue Sub-Zero with that heavier weight in the front is a low spinning driver aimed primarily at the fast swing speed, better ball striker who already has the accuracy and wants to maximize distance. Now make sure to also check out our under the hood previews of the entire Callaway Rogue family on golffitter.com, our YouTube channel, and stay up to date with the very latest on Golf Fitter Facebook and Twitter. But for me for now, it's Donal out.